We all know that you can sync Google Calendar with ClickUp Tasks and the other way around. But how do you actually make practical use of it to be more productive in your week? That's what I'm going to show you today, how I plan my week using the Google Calendar and ClickUp sync integration. So stay tuned. Hey everybody, I'm Yvonne Hyman with AskEV.com and I am a business efficiency consultant for digital entrepreneurs. So if you are a content creator or a coach that is ready to systemize, optimize, or automate your business, you're perfectly right here. So you better hit that subscribe button and the bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. As you might have seen in the last video, if not, pause this right now, go watch that. Get the basics down. We talked about how to sync and set up that sync between Google Calendar as well as ClickUp, both things, all the things with some pro tips in there. You got it. Just go watch the video. Oh, you already did? Cool, perfect, then we can go on right ahead. With the syncing happening, we are seeing all of the events that are in your Google Calendar in ClickUp. Now, I start planning my week in ClickUp around the events that are already shown in my ClickUp calendar, pulled in from Google. So let's get on over into my ClickUp. Nope, not Sandbox this time. We're actually going into my ClickUp so you can see how I handle all of this. Looking at this, you remember that pro tip? The whole setup and task? No, you didn't watch the video? Didn't I just tell you to watch that video? Okay. I'll tell you. We talked about just setting up a calendar specifically for your ClickUp tasks. And this is the reason why. That way you are not building this loop of tasks that are pulling into your Google Calendar and then pulling back in here. You can just turn that off. That's one of the reasons. Always make sure we keep everything nice and clean. Now, as you can see, all of these purple ones are events pulled in from my Google Calendar. You already can also see my regular daily recurring task of my daily DMO, my daily method of operation, cleaning up emails, you know, all that fun stuff. Got a video on that one too. Now on Sundays, when I plan my week, you already have a couple of tasks in here that are set up by recurring or whatever your planning already has been done, but there's always some backlog, isn't there? Let's look over here. We are in our task and we have overdue tasks. I seriously finally should set up that WooCommerce affiliate setup. Academy is going crazy, all the templates and all the things, but I don't have the affiliate stuff set up yet because I just haven't gotten to it. And as you can see, it's overdue. Let's just pull it in, go. Let's just schedule it. Now it's not overdue anymore. Now it's actually scheduled. And here's your pro tip number one. Now this is working this simple because the moment you click into the task, you will see I set a time estimate for that. I estimated that setting up the whole affiliate thing in my academy is going to take me an hour. Now there's two reasons for this. First of all, I can block my calendar out for that hour that I estimated this time to be. So I can easily figure out by moving around when I place that right here, this is going to interfere with appointments I'm having. I cannot do that this day. I need to do this on another day. It just doesn't fit in here. Or maybe just do a late nighter. That's fine too. Or let's just put it on another day. Awesome. That's possible because I added the time estimate in there. One thing that happens when you move them around, it goes from the past due date that you had and it changes to the new due date. Just letting you know, you might not be aware of that. Now I go through overdue tasks that need to get scheduled in here. And I really just pull overdue tasks into my calendar and just keep moving. Set up Academy recording. Let's just pull that over there. I don't even know. Oh yeah, I need to record a video for that one. Cool. Got that scheduled. All good. Once I'm done and going through my overdue tasks, I am going into my unscheduled task. Unscheduled tasks usually are, they might be subtasks, so you can just go past them. As you can see, send newsletter. It's a subtask to something. It's being handled by the main task. The subtask didn't get an actual due date or anything, which is why they're showing unscheduled. I just ignore those. But you know what? I seriously need to check and update my CRM. So let's pull that right in there. And I just pull the unscheduled task and pull them in here. Now, I happen to grab a task that is green, as you can see right here. Those are all tasks that are actually completed. Now, you might not see that in your ClickUp calendar. Why is that? Because I like to celebrate. This is a completed task. You get the complete behind the scenes now. This is a completed subtask that is done that we actually could pull out of here. But I like to celebrate my week and when I get stuff done and when I've been productive and when I stayed on track with getting all the things done. Now, the ClickUp calendar usually does not show completed task, and we do not have the simple link up here like we have in lists that says show completed tasks. Now, how did I do that? Filters. First off, you probably know location filters. I chose which of my locations, which of my spaces and folders and lists are showing in here. But I also added the end status is all. Let me show you. Let's just deselect all. What's gonna happen? Look at that. All of the green stuff is gone. Nothing green left. Which means when you are working through the week and you are getting stuff done, your calendar suddenly is going to be empty because you are completing your tasks and they don't show on the calendar anymore. That's no fun. So let's turn that back on. Select all. Confirm. Look! My electricity bill is already paid, even though that's not due till Friday. So is my Discovery card and my AAA card. Well good. Well good. And this is how I go through planning my week in ClickUp. Again, general project management, all of the tasks are already scheduled. I then go through the overdue task and I really just plug and play. I go through this list over here and you can change the sorting if you wanted to. I keep them by due date and I just grab the task and I just pull them over. Then I look through my unscheduled ones just to be sure I'm not missing anything. Again, remember the green ones, they're already done. You don't even have to pay attention to those. What of those need to get done? What of those haven't been scheduled? Just pull them into your calendar and there you go. But now what happens in your Google Calendar? Because we get that syncing too, right? Look at here. We got Friday, April 16th. We got the WooCommerce affiliate. Let's look at the 16th. There it is, WooCommerce affiliate. That means I can work out of my Google Calendar straight up. I don't have to find the right space in ClickUp and where is the task and where did I put it and where did I house it. All the things. I can just go right in here. We got the WooCommerce affiliate. I can open up the task and I can start working. Now you know why I am so excited about the ClickUp Google Calendar syncing capabilities. It really allows you to work on both ends, to see all of your calls and all the events that are happening in your calendar and through your scheduler. You even can go into your Google Calendar appointments, see what it is, who is going to be there, and open them up in Gmail right there. That's how simple it is. And as you just saw, the other way around works just as fine to open up your tasks straight from Google Calendar. And this is why I love it for productivity, efficiency, and all the things and all the things. Now, if you are a content creator or a coach ready to get productive and kick some booty in ClickUp, come join us in my Facebook group, ClickUp for Content Creators and Coaches. You'll find the link right below. I'll see you there.